بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسول الكريم أما بعد. Amongst the writings of the pious, إِذَا سَلَكَ بِكَ سَبِيلَ الْبَلَاءِ, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts difficulties, hardships, trials, sickness on you, then be comforted and be consoled. فَإِنَّهُ يَسْلُكُ بِكَ سَبِيلَ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ, because this was the road, the path of Anbiya alayhi salatu wassalam and the pious predecessors of the past. وَإِذَا سَلَكَ بِكَ سَبِيلَ الرَّخَى فَبْكِي عَلَىٰ نَفْسِكَ, and when ease and comforts come to you, then you need to be in tears and cry profusely because difficulties and hardships came to Anbiya alayhi salatu wassalam. I said there was an incident where there was a believer in a kafir, and they went fishing, and the kafir started making dhikr and mentioning his ilah and his god, and as he was doing this, أخذ سمكا كثيرا, he caught a lot of fish. وجعل المؤمن يذكر الله, the believer started making dhikr as well, but he never caught anything. He caught some fish, he managed to procure it. And as he was busy procuring the fish, they escaped. So he left home with nothing. And the kafir returned home with his nets full. So that angel that was dedicated to this mu'min was concerned. فَلَمَّا سَعِدَ إِلَى السَّمَاءَ أَرَاهُ اللَّهُ مَسْكَنَ الْمُؤْمِنِ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. So on his inquiry, Allah said, look at the abode of this person, this mu'min, what he will get in Jannah. And the farishta angel heard this, he said, Wallahi ma yadurruhu ma asabu ba'da ay yasira ila hadha. Forget the fish. If his whole life till he dies, he goes through difficulty, then it'll be worthwhile. You cannot compare it. وَأَرَاهُ مَسْكَنَ الْكَافِرِ, Allah showed him the abode of the kafir in Jahannam, and he said, وَاللَّهُ مَا يُغْنِي عَنْهُ مَا أَصَابَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا بَعْدَ أَن يَصِيرَ إِلَى هَذَا, that no matter whatever dunya and goodness and luxury and comforts he acquires, it will not be equivalent and it cannot suffice for the adab and the torment of Jahannam. So every difficulty a believer goes through, he should be hopeful of reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Since once Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu had some illness, he was complaining of stomach pain. So Nabi alayhi salam asked him, oh Abu Huraira, is your stomach hurting you? He said, yes, na'am ya Rasulallah. Nabi alayhi salam instructed him, qum fa salli, فَإِنَّ فِي الصَّلَاةِ شِفَاءٍ, that go and perform salah, because in salah there is cure and remedy, مِنْ كُلِّ دَاء, from all sicknesses and illness, all difficulties and hardship. So salah improves the mental state, the physical state. And that's why لَوْ أَنَّ نَحْرًا بِبَابِ أَحَدِكُمْ, Nabi alayhi salam has explained that if you had to leave every day, يَخْتَسِلُ فِيهِ كُلَّ يَوْمٍ خَمْسَ مَرَّاتٍ, make ghusl, wash yourself 5 times a day, would any dirt remain on his body, نَهْرٍ جَارٍ غَمْرٍ, or you had to go into the deep brook and cleanse yourself, Sahaba said no. So like that, the sins are forgiven, and external sicknesses, so internal illnesses and sicknesses, external sicknesses and illnesses, salah is a solution. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah used to say, فَصَلَاهْ مِنْ أَكْبَرِ الْعَوْنِ عَلَىٰ تَحْسِيلِ مَصَالِحِ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. Salat is one of the most important, greatest factors which assists a person, which is a remedy for one in dunya and akhirat. And it is also benefit for daf'i masadid dunya wal akhirah, from all corruption and problems and issues It will protect one from dunya and akhirat. وَدَافِعَ لِأَدْوَاءِ الْقُلُوبِ. And it is a cure for sicknesses of the heart. وَمَتْرَدَةٌ لِدَاءٍ أَنِ الْجَسَدِ. And it will remove sicknesses from the body. وَمُنَوَّرَةٌ لِلْقَلْبِ. And it lightens up the heart. It brightens the face. It makes the body fresh. And it is a means of drawing the risk. وَدَافِعَ لِلْظُلْمِ. And it is a means of protection from all oppression. وَكَاشِفَ لِلْغُمَّ. And all grief, worry, stress, it is a solution. وَنَافِعَ مِنْ كَثِيرٍ مِنْ أَوْجَاءِ الْبَطَنِ. And it cures sicknesses of the stomach, ailments of the body. So Salat has multifold benefits. It's for the people of Iman to have yaqeen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept a solution for every believer in Amal. If you look at it, just reading your normal faraid Salat, doctors have said in the early part of the morning, cortisone, which is a hormone which the body starts releasing in the early part of the morning, barakat ummati fi bukuriha, in the early part of the morning is the barakat of my ummah. So your body secretes this. So already our bodies have been governed. Likewise, in the later part of the evening, we read Isha Salat, secretion of melatonin, and that's preparation for sleeping. So after Isha, la samurata ba'da al-Isha, we should be in a habit of going straight after Isha to bed and getting up early. So that's the life of a believer. Not to sleep late and get up late. A person loses a lot of barakat, including his health. So we need to be very particular about that. Other doctors have mentioned that through Salat, it's a protection from very sick, many sicknesses. Some of them are like varicose veins, where approximately 10 to 20% of populations of the world suffer from this. Dr. Tawfiq Alwani, professor from the Faculty of Medicine, in his observation has said that between the harmony, when a person is in Qawma, Jalsa, Ruku, Sajda, all these positions, it assists in circulation, and the body in Sajda is in the same direction of gravity, which makes the blood flow optimal. Likewise, strengthening of the bones. So the body, the bones, has two stages of development. One is construction and destruction. As a person grows, there is construction. Then a person reaches a certain age where there is destruction and disintegration. So due to the movement of the body, there's different poles, and that affects the distribution and the functions of the bone cells. And according to these specialities which occur, experiments have done where a person reading Salat, and they found that bones become more strong, and it suppresses the softness and weakness. And they've done research for people traveling to space, and their experiments show that in the absence of gravity, the muscles grow weak and bones become soft, because there isn't the resistance of the force of gravity. Now imagine a person who is performing his faraid, performing his nawafil, how much movement, 1.5, 2, 3 hours a day, and that movement slows down the process of destruction. Dr. Thomas, who was also a specialist, said that it also assists in comfort. So psychologically, if a person wants to calm their nerves, tranquility of the heart, etc., Salat is a solution. Dr. Alex, who was a Nobel Prize winner in medicine, says that through Ibadat Salat, and he's specifically referring to Salah prayer, it brings about an energy in these body parts. And there is, according to his research, and these are his words, I've seen many patients who failed to be healed by drugs, but prayer intervened and healed completely from their diseases. Prayer is like radium. It is a source of energy. I have seen the effects of prayer in the treatment of various diseases such as tuberculosis, osteomyelitis, ulcerated wounds, cancer, and so on. We find that even in Western research, from strengthening the body to assisting in obesity, to reducing constipation, to all the benefits that have been listed. Again, this is what is in their ilm, in their knowledge. That's what science is saying. But we should not have yaqeen in that. We should have yaqeen in what Allah and His Rasul have said. So in any situation, فَزِعَ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ, we should turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, turn to salat. There was a sahabi who was called Aba Mu'aliq, and he was a businessman and he used to do business. And he was notorious for his piety, scrupulousness. And one day he was traveling, and on his journey, فَلَقِيَهُ لِسٌ, he was attacked by a thief, and he was laced with weapons. So this thief addressed him and said, ضَعَ مَتَاعَكَ فَإِنِّي قَاتِلُكَ, I'm going to take all your belongings, so put it one side, give me all your valuables, and I'm going to kill you. قَالَ شَأْنُكَ بِالْمَالِ, so the sahabi said, if you want the money, I'll give you all the money, if you want the goods, I'll take whatever you want. So this thief said, لَسْتُ أُرِيدُ إِلَّا دَمَكَ, I'm going to take whatever I want and I'm going to kill you, whatever happens. So the sahabi said, okay, فَذَرْنِي أُصَّلِّ, give me permission to perform my salat. So he said, صَلِّ مَا بَدَى لَكَ, read whatever you want to. فَتَوَضَّعَ ثُمَّ صَلَّى, so he made wudu and he read his salat, and his dua he made was, يَا ودود يَا ذَا الْعَرْشِ الْمَجِيدِ يَا فَعَالَ لِمَا يُرِيدِ أسألك بعزتك التي لا ترام وملكك الذي لا يضام وبنورك الذي ملأ أركان عرشك أن تكفيني شر هذا اللص يا مغيث أغثني يا مغيث أغثني يا مغيث أغثني. And as you were saying this, there was a horseman who was laden with artillery, and he came with a spear. فَطَعَنَ اللِّسْ فَقَتَلَهُ, and he stabbed the thief and he fell to the ground. So he asked, مَنْ أَنْتَ, who are you? فَقَدْ أَغَاثِيَنِي اللَّهُ بِكَ, because Allah has helped me through you. So this angel said, إِنِّي مَلَكٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِ السَّمَاءِ الرَّابِعَةِ, I'm an angel from the fourth heaven. لَمَّا دَعَوْتَ سَمِعْتُ, when you made this dua and you asked, I heard a clatter. I heard a clatter like a knock. Then you made dua again. يَا مُغِيثُ أَغِثْنِي. فَسَمِعْتُ لِأَهْلِ السَّمَاءِ ضَجَّةً, I heard a loud noise, a sound. Then you asked for the third time, Ya Mughithu Aghithni. So it was said, Dua'u Makroobin, somebody that is in need. So I told Allah, that is my calling, and I came. And this angel said, Abshir, glad tidings, Wa'alam annahu man tawadda'a wa salla arba rak'atin, whoever makes wudu, they read 4 rakat salat. وَدَعَى بِهَذَا الدُّعَاءِ, and they make a dua like this, then their dua will be accepted, مَكْرُوبًا كَانَ أَوْ غَيْرَ مَكْرُوبًا, whether they are in difficulty or not, whatever they are asking for, their request will be complied. Their request will be complied. In another narration we are told, Hakim's narration, 12 rakats, a person reads whether it's day or night. And those 12 rakats, in between every 2 rakats, a person does tashahud. And on the last tashahhud of the 12th rakat, a person should praise Allah and read durood on Nabi alayhi salatu wassalam. Thumma sujood. Then make sajda, and while you are in sajda, read Surah Fatiha 7 times. Then say, La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu lahul mulku wal hamdu wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir 10 times. Then read this dua, Allahumma inni as'aluka bi ma'aqid al-'izz min 'arshik wa muntaha ar-rahmati min kitabik wa ismika al-a'zam wa jaddika al-a'la wa kalimatika at-tamma. Read this dua. Then ask for whatever you want. After making dua and asking for whatever you want, come up from sajda, then make your normal salam like how you make your salam. The riwayat mentions, this is also in Allama Haythami is mentioned in his Majmu' al-Zawaid, Tabrani in Kitab al-Dua. وَلَا تُعَلِّمُهَا السُّفَهَا. Thus salat, this methodology, do not teach it to foolish people. فَإِنَّهُمْ يَدْعُونَ بِهَا فَيُسْتَجَابُونَ. Because they will make a dua and their dua will be accepted. So don't teach this method which has just been explained to foolish people, because whatever they're going to ask, they don't know how to ask properly and they might ask for the wrong things. So Hakim narrates, he said that Humayd ibn Harbin says, قَدْ جَرَّبْتُهُ فَوَجَدْتُهُ حَقًّا. I tried this and I found it true. وَقَالَ أَيْهَمُ بْنُ عَلِيٍّ. And this person says, قَدْ جَرَّبْتُهُ فَوَجَدْتُهُ حَقًّا. I also tried it and I found it's 100% working formula. So Hakim says, Abu Zakaria said, قَدْ جَرَّبْتُهُ فَوَجَدْتُهُ حَقًّا. I also tried it. So Hakim himself says, now at the end of the narration, قَدْ جَرَّبْتُهُ فَوَجَدْتُهُ حَقًّا. I also tried it and I also found that this amal is an amal that works, is a working formula. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to realize that in all points of need and necessity, our heart should go first to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The amal for today is when a person leaves the house, فَقَالَ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. If a person says this dua, بِسْمِ اللَّهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ, then a voice from the unseen says, حَزْبُكَ حُدِيتَ وَكُفِيتَ وَوُقِيتَ. That you now have been guided, Allah's guidance is with you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make your decisions, whatever you're going to embark on when you're leaving the house, which is good for your deen and your dunya. وَكُفِيتَ, and you will be sufficed for whatever your needs are, you will be sufficed. وَوُقِيتَ, and now Allah's special protection is on you. وَتَنَحَّى عَنُ الشَّيْطَانِ, and the shayateen run far away from this person. Another riwayat, one shaitan tells another shaitan, كَيْفَ لَكَ بِرُجُلٍ كُفِيَ وَهُدِيَ وَقِيَ. This person is so fortunate, how do we stand a chance? May Allah give us tawfiq of making amal. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.